words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be pleasing in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. I wanted to look today at the Judges reading. And the first thing that strikes me when I read it is that it's a form of what's called Midrash. So Jesus tells these stories and we call them parables. But they're a subset of what's called Midrash. These stories that were told in ancient Jewish traditions to help us think. So they are thinking stories. They're not necessarily supposed to be historical, but they are supposed to be a little bit historical in that they make some sense. So you can see quite clearly where Jotham sort of gets his first piece of historical connection. The citizens of Shechem and Beth Milo, they decide they want a king, and they've picked on Abimelech. And so Jotham wants to tell them a story about royalty. He says, listen to me, so God will listen to you. Listen. Don't just hear. Listen. There's a big difference, isn't there, between listening and listening. Sometimes we listen to have a response, and sometimes we listen to learn. And Jotham's asking to listen, to learn. And he sets the scenario, all the trees get together and they want a king. And clearly not entirely true, but they can maybe see where they're coming from. And the first thing he does is he chooses those that perhaps most people would think should be the king. You know, the olive tree. Olive tree produces olives and olive oil. When you're anointed with olive oil. When we do baptisms, we use olive oil. It is a really important produce. So important, in fact, that many people would think that naturally, if you were going to have a king of the trees in and around that part of the world, it would be the olive tree. And the olive tree says no, because to be king means I've got to give up my making of olives and olive oil. And then it goes on to, there's the fig tree, and then the vineyard, because the vineyard produces grapes. Grapes produce wine. Wine is good. In moderation. So you can see what's happening, is that the trees are kind of going through the list. And the first thing that I hear Jotham saying is that sometimes the people we think should be in charge aren't in charge because they've got something more important to do. And that means we should honor what it is that they are doing. You know, maybe it just means that the people who are in charge, our politicians and things, are some of the least useful members of our society. I don't know. Maybe. I feel sorry for politicians. To try and get anything done, they've got to make so many deals they can't get anything done. It's an amazingly complex system they live in. But anyway, so that's the first thing I hear. Then we get to the thorn bush, which is not necessarily particularly useful. The thorn bush says, if you really want me to be king, go for it. But remember that if that doesn't happen, you've now raised this power issue. You've made this a power issue. And when power comes, there's going to be conflict, isn't there? A fire will come out of the thorn bush and consume the cedars of Lebanon. Jotham is warning that when you buy into the power structures of humanity, then we're inviting ourselves into a place of conflict. And at the moment, if you look at media, and there's North Korea and America, the USA, and there are two very powerful people in their own local context. And when power meets power, you get conflict. But when power meets vulnerability, quite often what you end up with is abuse. That's no good. vulnerability means vulnerability. There is a chance for love and relationship and healing and growth. The next thing, though, that occurs to me. When I was in high school in South Africa, the local girls' school was not too far down the road. So we went to visit on a semi-regular basis, just to be friendly. And as we walked along, a lot of the houses had these thorn bushes with these beautiful red flowers that grew in them. And I'm not much of a gardener, even better now than I was then, because then I was terrible. But I ended up hearing the story about those thorn bushes, that they were carried by soldiers. Because what the soldiers would do is when they got to a place where they were going to be setting up camp for a period of time, they would plant them around the outside so that they'd make a thorn bush fence. And nobody was going over that enthusiastically, I assure you. So I can't help but wonder if perhaps there's another layer of hearing in what Jotham has to say. That is that when we do have times of power, when we do have power structures, the proper use of power, the proper use of power is not to dominate, but to be the protective hedge that goes around the vineyard to protect it from the wild animals, to be the hedge that goes around the olive grove, to be the hedge that goes around the fig tree. And so if we are going to be caught up in power structures, and the fact of the matter is everybody has power. In a church, I have the power to speak, and the congregation has the power to nap, or listen, or leave. If everybody leaves, I'm just talking to myself, and even I get bored of that. We all have power. And Jotham tells us that the proper use of power is to protect so that those things that are good and productive can do so in safety. Let us hear what he has to say. In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, Amen.